As we are all aware, on December the 8th, elections are being held here in Gibraltar. The three parties, the GSD, the GSLP and PDP, are all campaigning and rallying their supporters through social networks, the media and good old-fashioned hustings. At YGTV, we want to keep you up to date, and so we present to you our elections 2011 programmes, starting today with an interview with Robert Vasquez, political enthusiast, lawyer and keen blogger on Janito World. We asked Robert what advantages and challenges have arisen since going public with Janito World.
When I started Janito World, which is what I imagine you're referring to, I decided to remain anonymous because of the, not because I was in any way fearful of using my name, but because I didn't want people to read anything I wrote and be prejudiced by knowing who I was and my background, because in Gibraltar it is often the case that by who you are, people interpret what you write, and I didn't want that to happen. After I'd been writing it for a while, and when it started getting popular, I've never had an objection to making my views publicly in my own name, and that's the reason why I did it. And I put my name down because I believe fervently that in a democracy one should be able to speak one's mind without repercussion. The reality is that that has not been the case, and it has had repercussions on me. It has had repercussions on me in relation to my position in the Financial Services Commission, and unfortunately that person who commenced that process against me is the Chief Minister, who has so cowardly refused to give me the letter that he wrote. But there we go. That's the reason why one has power and one doesn't have power. But I have no fear of that, and I was always taught to stand up for myself, to believe in democracy, to believe in freedom of speech. And if that is the way he's going to act, he will pay the penalty, not me.
We wanted to know Robert's views on all the social networking political pages and groups that have been set up now in Gibraltar. Do these groups really help to increase the discussion and debate, or has the soapbox simply gotten bigger?
Look, I answered this a similar question on an interview that I did with GBC that's going to be broadcast on Monday evening. And I started with a quote from Lord Hailsham, who was Lord Chancellor of England in 1976. And he said in 1976 in a Dimbleby lecture, he said, "The United Kingdom has an elected dictatorship." Now, the United Kingdom has a system, a parliamentary system, that has many, many more checks and balances than ours does. And I won't bore anybody by repeating what I've already written, but I've written a lot about that. We were promised those checks and balances by Mr. Gatwan and the GSD government. 16 years later, we're still asking for those changes and they haven't made them. So if it's an elected dictatorship in the United Kingdom with those checks and balances, well, I don't think I need to in any way allude to what it is in Gibraltar. And I think people can come to their own conclusions as to the fact that instead of a democracy, we have a government by one individual, and what he thinks is best for people, that is not the best way to govern any place in the world, and certainly not Gibraltar.
So Robert, what are your thoughts on the campaign so far?
There has been no campaign so far. We are 2.5 weeks into the supposed campaign, and all we have is an announcement of who the candidates are. So let me comment about the candidates. I mean, there's been a lot of debate as to the relative strength of candidates. It is an issue, but it is not an important issue. I think what is in question in this election is style of government, failures of government. How do we want to go forward? And in that sense, what one has to have is regard to the policies of each individual party. And the policies of a party that has been in power for 16 years and has failed to deliver democracy in any meaningful way, and the policies of two other parties, the PDP and the GSLP, who are proposing democratic reforms. Now, I personally feel that one should give a chance to those who are making proposals rather than to those who made proposals 16 years and have so clearly failed to deliver them.
With the shuffling of leadership in the GSLP, and to an extent in the GSD, do you feel that this campaign will be fought on policies rather than personalities?
I do not recall Mr. Caruana or the GST fighting any campaign on policies rather than personalities. He already described the GSLP as the nasty party last night on television. That sets the tone for Mr. Caruana's campaign. In contrast, both the PDP and the GSLP seem to be wanting to fight on issues and have both said that they will want to fight on issues. I would like to see a campaign where the GSD is shown up as the party that fights on personality and the other two parties are shown up as the parties that fight on issues. And if we have that sort of campaign, I think I can prejudge what the result might be.
Some time ago, you announced that you would suspend your blog, Janito World, during the election campaign. Can you elaborate on why you made this decision?
I initially made that decision because as a campaign develops, the tribal divisions that exist in Gibraltar become more and more apparent. And the last blog I wrote, I've already published about 265 comments. And there are probably another 200 that I have not published because they become so personal, so abusive, so defamatory, and so unnecessary. And I wanted to avoid that. I have decided to keep writing the blog because primarily I have been asked by so many people that it is providing a useful service. I think whatever anybody says, my blog has dealt with new ideas, new policies, new issues that any party could have adopted. It so happens that in the main they have been adopted by the opposition parties, including the PDP, although they have no representation in Parliament, and totally ignored by the GSD, who were the ones who said that they would do the sort of things that I have been proposing. They are not massively revolutionary. I have not proposed anything that is not normal, common, and already in existence in other Western European democracies. It is Gibraltar that's so far behind, and the fault lies fairly and squarely in those who have not had the decency to keep their manifesto promises.